Farrier was the old term, and then for a while, horseshoer became the preferred one, and then kind of funny, nowadays it's kind of reversing again.
For Bobby Timmons, it started when a farrier was working on one of his new horses.
It was rather funny. He was a really good person to talk to, and we were asking him questions and asked, would you like to give her a try? Hey, and well, as ones that you're the first ones to say, sure thing, and then got underneath. Oh, legs are shuddering, shivering. It's like, stand up. Okay, give me a second, and I'll get back under, and we were the first people to do that. Yeah, and it's kind of funny, I was young enough, and he was like, hey, would you like to come work with me? And I said, sure, but we gotta wait till I get my learner's permit so I can drive over. Dad noticed there was an ad for a horseshoeing clinic over in Dupree by a guy named Lee Olson. And went over, and I learned quite a bit and found there was a lot more to it than I thought. He recommended a school in Minco, Oklahoma. It's a five-star horseshoeing school run by Dusty Franklin. Went down there and learned there was even more to it than I thought then. I've been lucky, I've met a lot of really good teachers. At the moment, I am a certified farrier of the American Farriers Association, and then hopefully in the fall, I go for the certified journeyman in exam and pass that one.
What happened next not only says a lot about Bobby, but it says a lot about his neighbors from around Union Center.
I think about a year or two after that, I was trimming some horses for Richard and Karen Butler. They run the insurance agency that we go through. And
okay.
Then later, Richard had sent me an envelope and said, if you wanted to, I would pay for you to go to this blacksmithing school in Sheridan, Wyoming. Hanging called him up, oh, sure thing. Hanging, I was very flattered because he paid for me to go to all three. He had three sets of classes, and he's got a hotel there that he let me stay in.
So armed with his farrier and new blacksmithing skills, Bobby loads up his mobile workshop and travels the region.
This is indispensable.
Indeed. Most of my work is in the Rapid City, Belfouche, Phillip area. I've got some I do in Burke, and then there's a bunch I'm doing in partnership with another horseshoer over East River.
Really?
Yep, but mostly through word of mouth. Both is, you know, working with different people and then, you know, doing horses and then the owners telling other people and going from there.
What do they like about you?
Well, I've had multiple people say they really like that I show up on time and the day that I'm supposed to be there. Well, you know, I talk with the owner and ask him about, what the horse does, how they've been. I look at the conformation of the horse, you look at the whole horse, you look at the shoulders, the knees, the fetlocks, you look and see if there's any deviation in there, you look at the feet and you see if there's any migration, you know, if they're toed in, toed out, if the feet are flaring to one way or the other. Keep going, checking off boxes till the person's done. There, I try pretty hard on that one.
Yeah.
And I try very hard to work with most horses, because most of the time, either they're just annoyed or if they're in pain, and you just got to work with them. I'm pulling up, squeeze lightly. I found on most horses, as long as you don't get hit mad and fight with them, they're usually better the next time around.
His smithing skills are certainly an asset to his farrier work, but he's thinking beyond that.
I've made some meat forks and some other small utensil items and hooks.
Okay.
Hooks, and just kind of been adding it to the horseshoeing and kind of working on getting it set up so during the wintertime I can build and set up product, and then once I get a inventory set up, go around to different places and see what they'd be interested in selling it.